finally meet. Patricia.
Hi, Tarek. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you, Legacy.
What's up, guys? How's it going?
Awesome, awesome.
So we have a flag lot, single level, ranch-style house. How much did you pay?
This is a 1.880 purchase.
This is gonna be fun.
So currently, it's just shy of 3,400 square feet. It's a three-bedroom, three-bathroom.
How much are you putting into it?
350.
And you flipped how many houses before this one?
We did about 5 last year, and it was lost some money on some. But then we found this one with comps listed at 2.7. So we figured, with almost $1 million between the purchase and the comp, how could we go wrong?
Well, you're definitely giving me a challenge, because this is like a project that would make me nervous. Let's do it, guys. Wow, look at all this light. You have a huge slider there, you have a huge slider there, but I don't like the fact that you walk right into this wall and that wall. So if this wall was gone, now you walk through the front door and this is the view.
I actually love that idea.
All right, look at it, it's working.
That's awesome. It's working.
The flooring's outdated. That needs to be replaced too, but what's back here?
So this is actually an additional family room. We've got this big double-sided fireplace. Maybe just open one side so that we actually have like a family room and a living room.
I think that's great, but you'll definitely need new sliders and windows throughout, and that's expensive. The kitchen is back here?
Yes. Yeah, right through here.
So some people might walk in here and look at the kitchen and say, wow, it's already remodeled. It has nice cabinets, nice appliances. But I think the kitchen needs to be demoed.
I was kind of playing around with the idea of opening up this wall and perhaps doing kind of an island overlooking into the living room.
I think you guys are on the right track, but I would run your kitchen to here, and now your kitchen is a 25-foot long kitchen.
What do you think about that?
I like it.
Okay, perfect. So we're gonna make a super-sized kitchen. You just need to make sure that you nail the design, because buyers at this price point expect it to be perfect. So, okay, wow, this is just all wrong. The design and layout is horrific. I envision right there is a huge steam shower.
That's really classy, especially at this price point.
Every space that's really like nice or popular, you wanna have a focal point. That's your focal point.
I love that idea.
What is your vision for this master bathroom? Because in a $3 million price range, like, the master bathroom has to blow people out of the water.
For sure.
I want to go a little bit more risky with the master and do something that's not really cookie cutter. I just love the veining of this black. It gives it more of a sexy vibe, more moody, kind of just like run it up that wall, and then maybe offset it with some more neutral tones on the side.
It has this cool, like, harmony together. It just right, like, seeing it right here, just I think it looks cool.
I think the bathroom design is going to be just perfect. So what is this here?
So this was my idea for the kitchen. I wanted this red oak to run horizontally. I feel like it's very neutral, very earthy, and then I've got this amazing piece of busy marble I was thinking of using as the countertops, and I kind of also wanted to run it up as a backsplash.
Okay, so are you realizing these are really busy cabinets? People are ripping oak out of their houses. They're not putting oak in their houses.
At this particular price point, we want something that's very unique.
What's throwing me off and what's gonna throw a lot of buyers off is the amount of grain. And then add a wild countertop on top of the grainy cabinets.
I don't see it as a problem. I think that the way it runs horizontally, it's so soft, and we've got this amazing marble that's going up the wall.
I'm gonna go with trusting her judgment on this one. I have yet to see something that she does that I'm like,
okay, hear me out. If this goes wrong, it will be the absolute biggest mistake you can make with this house. It's a $3 million house, so it's whether you want to take that risk or not.
I really feel like I'm willing to take that risk. I feel like maybe it could be a new trend.
So what you're saying is you're not going with my advice.
I'm gonna stick to my guns on this one.
Oh, no.
I don't want to be someone that's just like following a trend and doing something that's been overdone over and over and over. I'm just going to still keep looking forward and go with the vision that I have.
A wildfire broke out last night in the hills near Brentwood, probably less than 5 miles from Legacy and Patricia's flip.
On my way to meet the cabinet guy this morning, we got a phone call that there's a fire really close by. We're in a mandatory evacuation zone. That means we got to get everyone out of there. Just got to get them out.
You totally can see the fire from up here. We're stressed out because we don't know if the fire is gonna come over the hill at any time and just burn the house. Everything that we've done work-wise can go to zero, and that's a scary feeling. The Getty fire was massive and the evacuation lasted for a week. We're very thankful the house was kept safe, but we lost an entire week's worth of work. Not only that, but it's been 3 weeks since the fire's been put out, and we're still not running at 100% because we lost workers to other jobs during the evacuation. We're 11 weeks in, $35,000 in holding costs, and we're not even halfway done.
So I was just checking my social media, and I noticed Legacy posting videos of the flip.
What's up, party people? I'm here at the project, and literally, there's nobody here. I've got to call people to make sure that people get here to work because we're at a standstill.
And it looks like nothing has been done. We're in the 12th week of the project, and the house was supposed to be done week 12. They're paying 13 grand a month in interest. If they don't move fast, they're not going to survive. So I'm going to give them a call.
Stay tuned. It's your boy, Legacy.
Peace.
What's up, Tarek? How are you, bro?
Hi, how's it going?
It's going good for me. I mean, I don't know how you guys are smiling.
There's no one working on the house. It looks like it's still down to the studs.
The type of windows we ordered took about a month to come in. It's just been like delay after delay.
Next time that happens, you say, great, give me your manager.
And you want a discount because
you lost $13,000
in holding costs.
Tell them this is the last time you'll ever get business from me, ever.
They don't care, they're getting paid.
Imagine this, you're running 10 houses at a time with these same delays. You're talking $130,000 a month in losses from carrying costs.
That's $1 million+ a year.
Well, that just put things into perspective.
Your number one job is to get the projects done as fast as possible.
Go fix it.
All right, bye guys.
After talking to Tarek, I reached out to my sales rep, and of course he didn't answer.
This is just typical.
I'm mad because the level of disrespect for people not caring about our money.
Flipping a multi-million dollar home is never easy. Legacy and Patricia needed to walk the line between high-end design and appealing to the masses. It's been a struggle, but now's the time to see if they made it work. We're gonna be in my mobile office watching the open house go down.
So this is the most expensive flipping 101 house we've ever done. Are you nervous?
Yes. This is like the moment of truth. This is like, what are people gonna think of this house?
I wanna know what they think about those cabinets.
I like the entrance of the house.
I like the color. It's really
the
nice.
Black and white one?
Yeah.
Okay, it's starting.
Wow, it's like so big.
The layout and like the flooring is so bright. Everything just feels nice and big in here.
The space looks amazing. I mean, opening it up, it just came out great.
I love all the windows.
And
I like them black. Do you like them black?
I do like it black.
Good thing those windows and sliders came in, huh?
Oh my God. Oh,
if they only knew.
I like the cabinets. I just think it's a little bit too busy. The combination of this busy and this being busy.
That's what I told you.
Wow, look at this.
Oh, and they have a whole different tile on the side.
That was a great idea. I've never done that myself, and 100% I'm stealing it.
I like the size, not too big.
It's for the little ones.
All right, they're in the bedroom wing of the house. I want to see what they say about that master.
Oh, wow. I actually like it.
Really? I'm not sure about the wallpaper.
What do you mean you're not sure about the wallpaper? It's an accent wall.
Whoa. Look at this bathroom.
Kind of has like a nautical theme
right,
going on.
Right, yeah.
Over.
That's what we were going for.
I like the backyard.
Not enough sitting area.
So how does it feel when you hear people saying bad things about all your hard work?
It makes me doubt everything. Like, what if this house is just gonna sit here because people are not gonna like the decisions that I made? It's a little scary.
What was the price again?
$2,925.
Is there any wiggle room there, or is that like firm price?
Put an offer in and we'll see what we can do.
All right, well, we had some very interesting feedback. So what are the biggest lessons you've learned?
At the beginning, we were very lenient and people wouldn't show up and we would kind of just not really push. We weren't thinking of like how much money it's actually costing us.
As a whole, you guys did an amazing job. There's not many people that can come in and do one of their first flips and create a product like the house you guys created. But don't over leverage yourself. Don't pay too much money. Don't have delays on your project. Because on the next project, if you make the same mistakes, you're gonna be out of business. You can never make those mistakes again.